Before I get started with this video, I have to give you a warning. There will be a loud blaring sound from the video in which you are about to watch. So I would highly suggest if you have some earbuds that you turn the volume down on that particular video, except to only hear the voices and what they're saying. But it will be a loud blaring sound that will damn near pierce your eardrums. You just consider this your warning.
We are here at the Emmett Till Monument that represents the civil rights movement for blacks. What we want to know is when are all of the white people.
Okay, so y'all just heard that right there and saw that. Now, unfortunately, I had to cut the pictures up in the video and place them in chronological order based on the caption because for some reason when I downloaded the video under an MP4 format, it didn't bring the video over, but it brought the audio over. But you were able to see what was going on. So this video I was able to retrieve, it was on Tariq Nasheed's Twitter page, and I said I'm definitely going to make a video about it, especially since Emmett Till's memorial site or his monument has been desecrated and destroyed so many times over the years. I was one of the people that said either they need to stop putting it up or they need to put something there that will not be destroyed, make it bulletproof or something like that. And it looks like they listened to not only myself, but plenty of others. So what they have done is they've made the sign bulletproof. They've installed surveillance cameras there. And as you could hear by the alarm, they installed an alarm system, which, as you saw right there with those individuals, those condensed palm colored folks right there who were getting ready to mess with it again. Now, this is something I wish they would have done a long time ago, because then we would have been able to put some faces to these people. We already knew what type of people were doing it. We just didn't know who exactly was doing it. So they went out there with these flags. And by the way, not one of the flags they were holding up was the American flag or the state flag. Those were some white supremacist Aryan type flags. And they literally went out there with the intention of destroying the sign. But as you can see, as you could hear right there, they were met with a very rude awakening. And rightfully so. Because it says a lot when a group of people who weren't probably even around when Emmett Till was brutally murdered back in the mid-50s, still feel some type of way about this. They have a huge hatred in their heart for a boy who will be eternally 14 years of age, and they will not let it go. I don't know why a lot of people, especially those in my generation, feel that we live in some kind of utopia where a lot of stuff has changed from back then. They still carry and harbor a lot of that stuff to this day. As a matter of fact, I saw a picture and I said, on Halloween, I bet you it's going to be at least one blackface story I'm going to hear about. And sure enough, I heard about it the next day, where you had this family who looked like straight up trailer trash, had their children, they had two boys and a girl, and they had the boy holding a chain where he had his brother in chains and his sister in chains. But the only difference is, this is how they had it. The boy holding the chain was supposed to be Donald Trump. He had a MAGA hat on. The sister was in the back and she was supposed to be Hillary Clinton. The boy, the other brother, the other son, had blackface on and he was supposed to be Obama. These were little kids who did that. So don't sit up here and tell me that they're not passing this stuff on to their children, because they are. They like that way of life. When they say make America great again, that's exactly what they're talking about. I don't give a damn if they try to frame it and repackage it to be something completely different. It is what the fuck it is. And for them, that's their way of life. And people think, oh, it's going to die out when the older people go. No, they're instilling this in their children now because they know they're about to go. But back to this story right here. I'm glad that they finally did what many myself and others have wanted them to do as far as the sign goes, because I've done so many videos about this the sign being destroyed, being shot up and whatnot. I'm surprised many of them didn't. No, I'm not going to give them no ideas. But I'm glad they install surveillance cameras so people can see who is going there. They've made it bulletproof so it cannot be shot up, because that's what they like to do. They like to shoot bullet holes into the sign. And I'm glad they installed an alarm. Notice when that alarm came on, they scattered like roaches. And many of them couldn't walk fast enough because they fat and out of shape. Notice that some of the biggest palm colored supremacists are out of shape and sloppy. No wonder they're hating. They hate the way their life is. They hate their image. And when they see some people like us who have our shit together, for some of us, they frown at that, because they've been told for all their life that they are the better person, that they are the superior person. But they're learning the hard way that they are far from that. Few and very, 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 very far in between. But it is what it is. But I just wanted to bring this story to you so y'all could see that they have finally did something with this sign that looks like it's working clearly. And these idiots right here were the guinea pigs and didn't even know it. But y'all let me know what y'all think about this down in the comments, and I'll talk to you in the next one.